Greetings, race fans. I'm Colonel Failure, and this is Motorsport Madness. You're back with Bulldozer Power in the inaugural season, where we're performing quite badly. We're off to Munich for the next Grand Prix, but we've got some bits to take care of, because if we don't improve pretty quickly, the Munich Grand Prix may be our last. How's that for a sense of drama? Anyway, here we are back in the inbox. What have we got going on? Car condition update from Gary. Gary says cars are broken. Thanks, Gary. Good job. Channel 6 News. Rachel Noy is on the blower. She wants a word. Garuda Racing Z had a bit of a disaster in that race, finishing down in 8th. What's your analysis? Where's I Don't Care? The team looks weak. No, doesn't surprise me. He's an awful driver. They just got unlucky. Just in case he ever wants to drive for me at some point in the future. Who knows? Meanwhile, Sophie Richards from Central Sports Network is saying that Double Zero has definitely pushed to his limits in the race in the Ardennes, pulling off a number of boring. Firebird MRT driver came out on top, saying finishing second. Plastic, no, don't care about that either. And Firebird MRT boss, blah, 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 blah. Okay, yep, yeah. Well, there you go. That's all the news that's fit to print. So, apparently, Reverend Plastic wants to leave Firebird MRT. And again, I'm really not that fussed. I mean, is he any good, for starters? He's 24. He's actually, arguably, he's not as good as the drivers I've got. Which clearly just means that my car is hopeless. But he's dedicated, which means his mechanic likes him. He's a dangerous dueler, which means that his overtaking is good, but his consistency and focus is poor. And he's racing trucks. Yeah. More overtaking and some marketability. Interesting. I might try and snap him up at the end of the season. Now though, not that time. But we go back, the car repair is done. We go back to the sponsors panel. Sponsor offer 2. Show me the sponsor offers. There'll be a button here labeled sponsors. Offers 2. There we go. Right. So, finishing second or above. No, we're never going to do that. However, finishing second or above, deal is 6 races, upfront payment of 1.2 million. Sold. Get into my bank account. Well, that just bought me an extra 2 races of survival. So that's now pushing us pretty close towards the end of the season. And Maxwell's is going to run out in a couple of races' time. So we might be able to just scrape another sponsor that will help us get towards the end of the season. Well, up in the garage, we've got our entire team now available, ready to improve parts on the car. Gearbox pretty much good to go. The reliability even on the second one is, it's good enough. But they both have a pretty decent performance on the engine side of things. We've maxed the performance on one, and the other is also maxed on performance, which is less than helpful. We can improve on the brakes, however. What about the suspension? Suspension's good. Obviously we can improve the performance on this lot. So let's get our better suspension into performance engineering. And that will be done 3 hours before the race if I don't do anything else. But I would quite like to get the performance on, brakes up as well, 7 days after the race. What if we switch the team around 1 day before the race? We can have better brakes, we can have better suspension as well. Well, this sounds like a win-win-win-win-win-win scenario. It is tempting to go and research. Let's have a look here. How much is our... it's going to cost us $1.5 million for a better engine. I haven't got $1.5 million. So we're just going to leave it as is. We're going to make do with what we've got. So the latest round of the World Motorsport Championship is concluded. Carl Johnson there for Scuderia Rossini, finishing top with Bantam and Dom, second and third. That puts the overall standings to be Don Shoot Johnson, which sounds like a Sun headline, but you know, we won't look too closely into that. But then you've got the likes of Hawk and Parker and Lytle and White and Zuna, possibly, who might be the kind of drivers that would be happy to drop down a division or two in order to find themselves a brand new home. We'll have to wait and see. Okay, hot new news is that our design center has been finished. This is going to, it's going to make our expenses a little bit more expensive. But on the plus side, when we actually have the cash to do a bit more, you know, designing, that's going to be good. But as it stands right now, it's actually, you know, that's not so helpful. But we've got new buildings available. We'll have a look. I can't afford them, but we'll have a look anyway. Weather forecasting center, lovely, how terribly helpful. A wind tunnel, which improves front wings, that's nice. And a simulator for the rear wing. Mm-hmm. And a handling center. See, handling center would be nice, but obviously I can't afford any of this stuff. The Sacred Council of Elders are back again. What have we got going on here? Occurs to me, occasionally your new team principal might be interested in taking a particular motion to the other members of the GMA. I'm not entirely sure who Ernie Heckelrock is. Oh, he's the GMA president. Now, naturally, I wouldn't be a GMA supremo if I just allowed you to choose a vote without some form of compensation. It seems to me that... that he's going to give me £1 million. Let's have a, what have we got here? So I get to choose what we vote on, and he'll give me £1 million. That's odd. But, you know, I'm not complaining. All right, well, what do we like the looks of? Right, what have we got? Extra length practice sessions. What else? Changing the lap number in races, yeah. Changing the layout, change a track, add a track layout, add a track, 100 kilometers per hour speed limit in the pit lane, very high. I wonder if he was going to offer me £1 million per choice, because if so, I'll take all of them. You know, I'll quite happily, you know, sell out entirely. Spec engines. Ooh, that could be interesting. Let's do that. Yeah, this is going to help me significantly. Because, you know, even next season I might struggle to get a hardcore. Total cost is £1 million. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, I am not paying £1 million. What's it say? Oh, I can pay him £1 million to choose a vote. All right, no, clear off. No, I'm not that fussed. No, seriously, I mean, if you were going to pay me £1 million, I'll do whatever you like, chump, but I'm... No. What do you think, I'm made of money? You corrupt individual. Oh, yeah, obviously, I realise I'm being just a little bit... dishonest there. Anyway, right, what have we got going on here? European Racing Series driver Faith Anthony has revealed she's begun meditating to help herself relax before the race, as long as she doesn't meditate during the race. I met a Swami while I was traveling around India, said the 34-year-old American driver. He really turned me on to meditation and the way it can soothe your mind. Some drivers out there like to sit in the simulator, some might like to go to sleep, but I find meditation is the best way to keep my nerves down. Focus plus two. Excellent. Good work there, Faith. Although, you know, she's... at 34, she is one of the older drivers in the series. So, you know, I don't know how many series she can expect to be left in. Anyway, from the Asia Pacific Super Cup, latest race coming from Yokohama, Curious, 4-star, and Zero, the top three races, which puts Curious, for now, it's the same thing you fall. Chinar, Curious, and Otti now leading the championship, although Chinar is running away with it. Yet more harassment in my inbox. What have we got here? Garuda Racing have got a wind tunnel. Bully for Garuda Racing. It only cost them 7 million quid. Up yours, Garuda Racing. Kurt's on the phone. Just a reminder that we're currently ninth. This is better than our original target of last. Keep up the good work. Cheers, boss. Right, so talking about Munich. 25-lap race, 3 miles per lap. There's a lap record, that's good. Sunday, 40% chance of rain, that's exciting. Without too many chances for the cars to get to full speed, it really favours excellent acceleration. I've got that. Soft and medium compounds, track's quite abrasive. Our car's one of the best on the grid when it comes to tyre wear. That's because we don't go very fast. Andre is in. What's going on, Andre? He'd love it if we could build a test track at the HQ. It'd really help him improve his skills as a racer. He's got a broken neck. You know what would help him his skills as a racer is not having a broken neck. He's also had some of the mechanics say that we might have the space to build a powertrain unit, which would massively help any new engines we design. What do I think? What I think there, Gomez, is that if you won a few more races, then maybe I'd be able to afford this stuff. You start winning, I'll start building. So it looks like the World Motorsport Championship is at another race while we've just been hanging around. Shoot, walking away with the podium championship first place thing. In Milan, with Fishburn and Johnson following up rapidly behind. Now, interestingly enough, that allows Johnson to move into contention for second place overall. Shoot is by no means certain to win the season, although he is currently in the lead. All the email, all the time. The Munich preview roundup again. Milan Z is going to be going in at the top of the driver standings. Former driver Michael Tellman isn't expecting to see that change. Can't see General Max making up too much ground in Germany. Z is driving too well. Don't honestly care. Away from the front of the pack, struggling Predator Racing is currently hoping to see some improvements this weekend in Munich. As the circuit, blah, 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 bing, 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 bing. Kurt. Hello, Kurt. Always nice to see you. Spotted a number of transactions coming out of the IG account that you find concerning. If this spending pattern continues, you're likely to be very low on cash. Kurt, here's the thing. The transactions coming out of the account that you're seeing is me, like, you know, paying bills and what have you. And, you know, covering the cost of going racing. Now, if you weren't such a flaming cheapskate, then, you know, maybe I could invest in something that would actually give us a fighting chance of not coming flipping mid-table. You know what? You've asked for this, Kurt. Where are you? Come here. Let's push the buttons until we find him. Where is it? Chairman's happiness. Come here, chairman. I want to talk to the chairman. Where's the chair? There he is, look. You, Curtis. I want... this now I 800 grand a race. I've got 3 races left in my budget. Give me money. He's very happy. It's going to be less happy afterwards, but he's going to give me 1.5 million quid. He's not happy about it. Well, I wouldn't be particularly happy about it if I was hit for 1.5 million quid just on a random Thursday afternoon. Right, I'm not going to spend it because that's 1.5 million quid is a new engine. But I would rather hang on to that to guarantee that we finish the season. And then if we land a bit more cash as we progress, then maybe I'll think about spending some of it. But we've got enough to be getting on with as it is. Anyway, mail. What have we got here? Factory staff are just kicking around. All right, well, you know, you could have woken me up before you decided, we haven't got anything left to do. What should we do? Oh, I don't know, let's sit around. No, let's not sit around. Let's do some flipping work. Right. Reliability on this second gearbox could be beneficial, but at the same time, second set of suspension might be good. We've now got a decent set of brakes. That's promising. Reliability on them's fine as well. I've got both engines maxed, and the problem is that neither of them are any flipping good. I don't know. Yeah, that's a toughie. That's a dilemma and a half. Okay, right. Yeah, we'll improve the reliability on the improved secondary gearbox. Might as well get that up to as high a standard as we can, and we'll also do the same on this this beefy set of brakes we've got. Switch the staff round, because Inez, as we all know, is a load of rubbish. Get to work. So here we are once again, choosing the sponsor who is going to hopefully pay up if we do well. I'm going to go relatively conservative as usual. We'll go with Wan Chai, since we have, you know, we have a chance of actually pulling that off. Right, let's slap some new parts on Faith's car. Right, where are you, Faith? You want these ones? You've already got those ones. That's good. You've also got the best gearbox. You've got the best engine. Yeah, that's good. And you've got the best suspension. I can't do anything else for you there, Faithless. You know, just make good decisions. Win the race. So it's a nice woody track, this one. Apparently not so much on the engine, more on the gearbox to kind of dictate how your performance is going to go. Anyway, let's go with our usual setup here. And let's have a quick look at the weather forecast. Weather forecast is showing potential for rain in a couple of minutes. That's okay. Now, I'm going to change based on some of the feedback from the fans in the after the last race, suggested that what I really ought to be doing is sticking my downforce in a position that is at the end of the suggestions from the mechanic, and that way we're only going one way afterwards. So if we go right there, for example, on the Gomez, we'll actually drop the tire pressure. Do we need to drop that? We don't need to drop the tire pressure on Gomez. He's going to drive conservatively anyway, because that's kind of the aim. Acceleration will stick there, and we'll drop the handling to let's stick it right. That's silly. So we'll go with a fair shake of understeer. Get the gear ratios about there. Tire choice is on mediums at the moment, lightweight. But, you know, that's fine. That's fine. Meanwhile, let's get Faith set up as well. And we'll get her downforce in the wrong place as well. I think it's a terrible idea, but we're going to try it out nonetheless. Very low downforce. Hopefully she doesn't stack it. Now, with her tyres, I will decrease the tyre pressure. I'll leave it alone. There we go. Glad we could have this conversation. Right, stick the oversteer on like that. Low downforce with oversteer and greater top speed. She's going to have a miserable first outing, but hopefully we should get the kind of information that will allow us to get things going. So, Andre understeering, Faith oversteering. We'll see what we see. There we go. Faith's all set. Yeah, race trim. Two laps. She won't be out for two laps. We'll be lucky if we finish a lap, but you know, we're gonna send her out immediately. We'll do the same with Gomez as well. Off you jolly well trot. We'll get both of them on fairly aggressive. Hopefully it will allow them to To learn quickly is the goal. Anyway, we're following Andre on his outlap. As soon as we have any reports back from the drivers, we'll bring them in. So Faith is saying that the handling feels superb, which, well, I mean, it's not what I'd expected, if I'm honest. But I'm going to bring her in. Whereas your man Gomez, he's saying that he needs to be feeling a little bit more responsive. So we'll bring them in, make a couple of adjustments, and see where we get. And that looks like just the barest hint of rain going on here. Faith setting some very respectable sector times. But obviously she's probably one of the first people actually out there to do so. Okay, let's see what we've discovered. Right, terrible aerodynamics, good handling, terrible speed balance. Okay, right. Well, for the next session, if we want to keep the, I suspect she wants a little bit more understeer there. So if we bring the suspension in some. Now, if she really hates the downforce, then we'll add a chunk and a bit of downforce. Shorten them gear ratios some. I still think that that's too much oversteer, but Faith knows what's what. How are we doing on the tyres? Do we go intermediate? What's the forecast? The forecast is lots of rain. We're going to go straight for intermediates. We'll let the chips fall where they may. Meanwhile, from Gomez, he's learned a little bit more, but his opinion of the car, hates it, and it kind of sucks. So, that's easily resolved. Downforce it up, or upforce it down, depending on your point of view. Now that's giving him a little bit more oversteer. So actually, Faith's oversteer liking it appears to be about right. I still think probably around there, mid chart would appear to be a good place to go, and then we'll keep the I think we'll stick with that. We'll stick intermediates on here as well and see what it gets us. So a quick chop and change. I would far sooner get good information out of my drivers for the race itself than set, you know, some kind of very exciting lap time in the practice session. Getting the car settings right is one of the few things that we've done consistently well throughout the season. But we'll see how that goes. Now, they're both being held up by some joker at the moment. But as long as they're learning what the car does, I'm okay with that. In fact, Faith, you know, just don't hang around. Just, you know, get past them. Now, Gomez is preferring the new aerodynamics, which is expected. Yeah, and Faith is as well. But this is still experimental, so I'm going to tell them both to come in. So that I can have a look and see what they've actually accomplished. And actually, given the amount of water on the track, although is it easing? That's the exciting question. Rain's about to ease off. Gomez also digging the handling. That's nice too. My two drivers, the only guys out there on intermediates. And that's probably down to the number of times I bring them in. I don't let them complete full laps. Right, okay, let's have a look and see what we've got now. So Faith has gone for... She's okay with the downforce. Good handling, good speed balance. That means we can probably go further. So here we are on the first one. Handling, we definitely need to understeer a little more. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Right, so even more downforce. This feels wrong to me. But with that much change, If that turns negative, we'll know it's in between the two settings we've had so far. The oversteer is too much. So let's drop that to about there and see if we can't get that right. Speed balance is good. Previous speed balance. So lower speed balance, better. Well, we'll try it. I mean, that's quite an aggressive change for a third outing. The water's gradually coming back off the track, so we'll stick the soft tyres back on. I don't want to use a new set, so these are effectively scrubbed. Right, get out. Meanwhile, Mr. Gomez. He's already got some good car knowledge, that's helpful. He's very happy with the downforce. Excellent handling, excellent, great on the speed. So if we just make minor adjustments from here, we could be onto something. In fact, if we leave that where it is, just a fraction more downforce, that might do it. That might be too much. But hey, you know, you get no points for not trying things out. Medium tires back on. Off you go. So this will be their final outing. We'll let them complete the session on the setups they've got now. And then, after doing that, we'll make a guesstimate in pre-race prep based off the feedback that we've had from them. Obviously, this is not a competitive environment, but it would be quite nice to see a practice time that was pretty respectable. Because, well, if nothing else, it would make a change. Now, it looks to me like weather forecasting is going to play a critical role in today's race, given the likelihood of a bit of water happening on the track. That's going to make a bit of a difference. Playmoto there, the oft commented on, oft written about in the media, Playmoto setting the fastest practice time. He's six seconds off the overall best lap time that has ever been achieved on this track. But then he is only running medium tyres. Were he running tyres that weren't so medium, he might do better still. So there, Gomez coming in with a 1:43, and Anthony with the third fastest time in practice. And that means nothing at all, except very nice. So very happy with that finish there, 1:41, 1:43. That's very, very nice. I mean, if we could replicate those finishing places on race day itself, I would be over the moon. It's time for a bit of social media. Bulldozer Power is so much better than Eastwood Motorsport. Even their colours are better, lol. Thank you, Franca. Enlightening comment as always. Motor Racing Magazine. Looks like Macht is driving well this weekend. Wonder if that can continue into the don't care. UKSN, Victor Keller. Does the track here at Munich suit the Bulldozer Power car or something? They're looking like they're going to get a good result this weekend. Obviously, basing his forecast there off the practice session. And the Evening Herald, Arnold Boycott. The engineers have done a job with Faith Anthony's setup because they're showing some impressive pace out there. Well, you know, the practice session is in no way an indicator of how we're going to perform in the race itself. We only need to finish ninth in order to get a good chunky bonus. And it's raining from the get-go. Oh, dearie me. This could really put the cat amongst the pigeons. Second lap is forecast to be dry and then two laps of wet. I'm going to bank on Faith coming in early, as I always do. Right, Andre, yeah, have your race trim. He's good at intermediate tyres. Well, ain't that lovely. Faith, meanwhile, race trim and intermediate tyres. Well, I mean, there's not a huge amount of choice in the matter, is there? Right, go to the car setup. Actually, Faith's wasn't all that terrific at the end of the day. I think it was just general improvements mixed with the right tire compound for the end of the session. Anyway, what have we got here? So he hated that, right? And then he thought this was pretty good, and now it's only good. So actually, a little bit more on the old downforce, or rather, sorry, a little bit less on the old downforce will make his Gomez-ness just a little bit happier. Anyway, let's try that. Let's give it a bit more front wing, get the nose in fast. Handling is still good. The speed balance is great. What else have we seen? Speed balance has been in the past great. So I mean, you know, we can chance a little bit more. No, I'm gonna leave it alone. We're leaving it alone. That's it, being left alone. Right, we'll go out on these tires. I'm not thrilled about it. That's the thing, is, you know, we've got 4 or 5 laps where the track is going to be damp, if not worse. I wonder whether it's going to be worth risking it with more aggressive tires. But there we go. We'll stick with that. Meanwhile, Faith's very happy with the downforce. The handling, I think, has been better. So we haven't actually improved the handling at all. Okay, right. The handling is still good. So maybe a little, I don't know. What does she want? What do you want from me, Faith? What do you want? I haven't moved the handling. She likes the speed balance. And to be honest, with that kind of practice finish, why would I mess with it? Let's just leave it the hell alone. All right. I think I could do some tweaks and maybe get more out of it. But we'll just leave it alone. And I'm going to give Faith a full tank of fuel to get started. I dread to think. And hope that that we pull it off. We'll just have to see. It's not a strategy that I'm overjoyed about. Right, driving style. We're gonna push as we always do. Initially, to try and get a little bit more early position, and then once the tires start heating up, we'll ease back on them. Anyway, Mush and Gomez up front, Plastic, Megahertz, third and fourth, Longo, Shaw on the third row of the grid, and then Playmoto, Faith Anthony on fourth row. In ninth and tenth is Sane and Cybergal. Then 00, Bird Dog, 11th and 12th, and V Hagen and Trolley Fodder on the 7th row. Ruto, Plastic, rumoured to be leaving Firebird MRT at the end of the season. Interesting choice. Then Trix, Kneehertz, Macht, and Z, the current championship leader. So we're on the grid. We're following Gomez because he's on the front row of the grid. Can he get anything out of the start? It wasn't a fast start. Not a fast start from Gomez. And there he is. He's lost his second place already. Oh no, he's fighting for it. Well, that makes a change. No, there it is. It's gone. Faith's dropped a ninth. Gomez dropped a third. No. Gomez says no. No, I will not drop to third. I want second. Now he's going to have to put his foot down if he's going to keep up with Mush, that's going to be pretty important. Faith is not off to a good start, down to 13th, and she's swearing at just about everybody right now. Gomez no longer with his broken neck, so that seems to have fixed itself. Gomez challenging all the way, lost his second place again, but he does have the inside. No, he can't do anything with that either. He's now lost third place, he's down to fourth. Okay. So now we're into the dry patch that was expected, but then we've got, you know, three wet laps coming up after that, and I don't know if it's going to make any difference. Longo has crashed. Hagen and 00 are both in the pits already. I wonder if they're switching tyres. while they're in. It would be an interesting choice. You know what else? Let's go on the tires with Gomez. Given that we're good at protecting our tires anyway, and they should outlast the amount of fuel he's got, I can't see any harm in thrashing them and getting the temperature up a bit. I mean, Anthony's still in contention, but she's losing places all over the place. She is just no good on these tires. Her setup was arguably very good in practice, but the tires are doing nothing. No, both Hagen and Double Zero have come back out on intermediate tires. I don't know what happened there. Some kind of collision, maybe some sort of stop-go penalty. We'll have to wait until we got Andre here questioning the sanity of staying out on intermediate tires. Shut up, Andre. Track has dried off. Let's pit for slicks. I know what the weather forecast is. It's going to rain. You'll be very grateful. Now, the interesting thing is going to be if anybody else decides to go in and tire up while the track is drying out. And it is drying out at quite a rate. And that's Gomez dropping a sixth. Remember, we need to finish ninth or better in order to really benefit from our sponsorship this weekend. Faith is now down to 17th. God's sake, Faith. Gomez, meanwhile, is doing a fine job at holding fifth, but not for long. He's going to lose it now. Nope, Hertz hasn't got the bottle to go up the inside there. Now, here's the point where we find out if our weather forecasting is worth a damn. We've got at least 5 laps of rain if this forecast is in any way accurate. And if you look at the tyre wear of both Gomez and the rest of the field, and Anthony for that matter. Anthony, no, wrong button. This button, hit it. Come on, don't hang about. Put your foot down, woman. Now, she's got no one behind her who hasn't been to the pits already. I don't know why she is off her game, especially after such a remarkably capable practice lap. Well, up the tempo here just a little, and the rain is coming down. Now, if we can time the end of the rain with a pit stop, assuming the rain is going to end, then, you know, exciting things could happen. Faith has already capitalized. She's made up 2 places since being told to, you know, put the hammer down. And she's only a second behind Trix. And, you know, that would be a benefit. I would love to see both my drivers in the top 10. I can't see it happening, but, you know, we hold out hope. Still another couple of laps where water is occurring. 5 laps of fuel left for both drivers. It would be very nice to know what the weather was expecting to do. Gomez back into fifth. He's having a great race, but he is now absolutely massacring those tires. So I'm gonna ease him back off some. Faith has got a little bit more give in the tyres before she needs to ease off as well. The track is getting damp, but if I was on mediums here, we could have stolen a pretty hectic start to this race if we'd gone out on mediums initially. Gomez now down to 8th, Faith in 16th. This is again looking like a stinker of a race for Bulldozer Power. What have we got here? Dog, I made contact, and that's Gomez has got to go in for a flipping penalty. Oh, for love of pity sake, Christ almighty. What have we got? More rain, higher temperature. Well, we're going to keep him on intermediates then, aren't we? Fuel options, fill her up. So he's got a drive-through penalty. He's broken something. He's broken his rear wing. That I think we can say is Gomez probably out of contention for the remainder of the race. Bird Dog needs to learn how to drive. Well, he is wearing a giant dinosaur suit, but there we go. That's that. Gomez is no longer of interest. So we're now watching Faith, and look at that. That's a maneuver. Faith there pulling 13th place out of the bag. She's only got a couple of laps of fuel left. And we're going to want her to capitalise on. Oh, look at it. Look at her go. Come on, Faith. Whip it up. Now, I'll probably bring her in pretty soon. But now's the time to give it all you got. Maybe one more lap and then we'll bring her in. We've got a drive-through penalty going on for Gomez. Stuff you, Gomez. You waste of space. But Faith is really... All right. I tell her to, you know, not spare the horses. And clearly she doesn't give a monkey's about the horses. She's being overly nice to him. Yeah. Bad pit stop for Gomez as well. But, you know, like I care. Right. We're going to pit Anthony at the next opportunity. The forecast is saying it's going to continue raining. I don't think the track's going to get too much wetter, he said. That's not going to come back and haunt me. How the parts looking? Parts are looking tasty. Pit strategy, let's risk it. So this is going to be pretty important. This pit stop is going to make all the difference. Thank you, tooltips. Yep, yep. You're telling me more than I need. Right, we're in ninth. We've pitted in amongst a whole bunch of other people, but the top seven drivers have yet to pit, which means they will do in relatively short order. Anthony coming back out in 12th place. That's not bad at all. Gomez now down in 17th. Well, now he's doing another drive-through penalty? Oh, well, whatever. Frankly, I can't sack that guy fast enough. Maybe he's got a bright future in the sport, but I'm not feeling it, and he certainly doesn't have a bright future with this team. I just don't think he has the kind of temperament that I want, and there goes Faith burning the places that she had so skillfully won not so long ago. My left knee hurts, the only driver yet to come in. I don't know what's going on there. I don't know if they've got some kind of solar-powered car helping to keep it out a little bit longer, because I would have run out of gas ages ago. But, you know, we're sticking with it. This could still end well. We're only three places away from where we need to be to capitalise. Forecast is more rain. The water on the track is lackluster. I mean... It's hard to say whether starting on a medium tyre strategy would have been beneficial. I mean, it's way too late to talk about that now. But, you know, while there's not a lot else happening, I'm going to talk about that now. Double zeros in the pits. I can't see him winning. I'm just saying, can't see it happening. General Macht, meanwhile, the other driver in contention, is up in third. But, you know... What do I care about other drivers? I mean, you know, I barely care about my own. Come on, let's get some pace there, Faithus. The tyres are a reasonably good condition. They're fairly cool. Parts all look fine. Let's attack a little more. I don't mind coming into the pits a lap early, particularly if it looks like a change in tyre. Would be a judicious move to make. But right now, Faith is not pulling out the kind of performance that we need if we're going to get a top nine finish. And that basically means we either need an accident up ahead or we need to do some very... Oh, look at that for a move! Oh, that was nice. Very nice indeed. Double overtake. What do you say about that? Well... What we say about that is you need another 4 seconds. You need to pick up another 4 seconds. That's all important. Right, she's going to start eating the tyres. So we'll ease off there. We'll ease off the fuel at the same time. She's going to be coming in early anyway after that stint. But that was some good stuff. I mean, we'll probably lose the position back to Milan Z, who is a very good racing driver. What have we got? Okay, two more laps of intermediates, and then it will be medium tyres. Now, I've got 4 laps of fuel, allegedly. I think if I bring her in into lap 14 and come back out, we're going to gamble on a super soft compound. and see if we can't leapfrog our way up, providing it's not too slippery to start with. I mean, the water on track is not going up by much. It's likely to be falling away quite quickly. This is the strategy. This is why Kurt has dipped into his pocket and given me £1.5 million, because this is the kind of decision that rests on my shoulders. We've lost position there. It's going to be a tricky one, but we sure as hell aren't coming back out on intermediates. I think we have to gamble on the race drying up significantly when the rain eases off. Tire deg's really bad. Don't care. I honestly don't care. Deg, not degradation, I am reliably informed, is in fact degrees. Very hot tires mean extra tire wear. Right, she's going to pit this lap. We're going to chance it. I mean, at this stage of the game, there is nothing to be done. 9 laps left after the pit stop. We're going to put 10 fuel laps in. This is going to be so close. She's going to run out of fuel. We'd have to do a splash and go. I don't want to do that. Do we stay out one more lap on what we've got? We'd have to ease back. I think you have to go for it. We're going to try a fast pit stop again. Gomez, meanwhile, let's tell him to come in as well. What the hell? Right, you can have medium tyres. Fuel options, yeah. Fill it up. Park condition, don't care. Pit strategy, sure thing. Okay, so Faith will be coming in this lap. Let's tell her to just, you know, absolutely thrash what she's got until she comes in. Oh, Gomez has come in early. Oh, that's interesting. But he is back out in 16th. So no loss of position. And he's the first out on sporty tyres. I want to come in for Inters. Shut up. Now, if we pull this off, so there's Trolley Fodder also coming out on slicks. General Max come out on slicks. Hertz is out on mediums. Mushenshaw on mediums. Gomez on mediums. We're clearly not the only team to be gambling. Oh, be quiet. And you be quiet. My drivers are just complaining like you wouldn't believe. The forecast is staying dry, which means that that gradually we're going to get water off the track, and the drivers will see the wisdom in my strategy. Now, 12th is not going to do it. 12th is not going to do it, and we're 20 seconds behind 11th place. We're now up into 10th. This is good. 10th is good. We like 10th. We're 7 seconds behind. The top 3 still have to come in, but they will exit ahead of us. And I can't see Faith Anthony being able to hold the fuel together enough to remain in contention, or in fact in the race at this stage. Now we've got 11 seconds, 13, 14 seconds over Shaw, who's running the less sporty medium tyre. So if I were to, I don't want to do it, but I'm gonna tell Faith to just ease up a little. Right now we'll go for the finish. Gear changes feel wonky. What's going on with you? Your gearbox is down at 28%. Well, you might as well come in then. Come on, we'll fix it. You gigantic waste of space. There you go. We'll give you enough fuel so you definitely finish. Fix that. Yeah, whatever. Pivot strategy, balance, sure. Now, unless there is some kind of massive car pile-up type deal, Gomez is really just not into it. Faith has got a chance, but she's going to need a significant amount of luck. Looking at the cars ahead, General Macht, maybe Milan Z, if they have to come in for an additional pit stop. That could lead to an opportunity, but I have had to ease off. I have had so many occasions where we have run low, if not entirely out of fuel, that easing back a little bit is the only sensible thing to do. But we're losing position on track all the time. We're not closing on anybody. The gap between us and Trix, who is the next car back, is remaining fairly constant. Bit of hold up with the brakes. Good. Yeah, Gomez there losing a bit more time. That's what we like to see. But Gomez is now the next, the next car on the track behind Anthony, which is nice. So four laps remaining. I've got five laps and change of fuel, but I don't want to do it yet. I will tell Faith to put the hammer down when we're confident that that she can at least finish the race. We're now 6 seconds back. Is it so much to ask for one of these fools to have to pit? Or, you know, a collision. Actually, Trix is now catching up. We're going to have to up the tempo. There we go. Gomez now, having overtaken Bird Dog, has got 16th place under his belt. That's pretty promising. But really, all eyes in the crowd are on Faith and whether she can do anything about it. And in fact, it doesn't really matter. She's about to lose her position to Trix. And that's annoying. Gomez just set his best personal sector too. I don't know what she was waiting for. He, even. Faith just set a personal best lap. Well, terrific. I mean, it's a bit late to be handing out medals now. I mean, we need a superhuman push to make these last couple of laps count for anything at all. And I'm not seeing it. Go on, give it everything you got. Don't hang around, let's do it. We run out of fuel, so be it. We've got money to finish the season anyway. We might as well see if we can't get a... Steve Mush is retired. From where? 13th. That doesn't help. That means Gomez is going to start getting all egotistical. About, you know, how he held it together singularly and what have you. Come on, Faith. Anything? I don't think she's got it in her. I don't think the car's got it. I don't think she's got it. And we definitely came in for the tyres at the right time. But I can't help but think that had we gone for a three-stop strategy instead of two, starting on faster tyres so that we could have made that first pit stop, switched to intermediates at the right time, we could have been coming up with solid gold. But hey, you know, that's just a coulda, shoulda, woulda. We're on the last lap. We've got the fuel, we've got the tyres, but we don't have the position. 8 seconds back from where we needed to be. And we just lost another place. Brilliant. Good. Couldn't hold them off for one more lap. Is that what you're telling me? Couldn't do it. Position 11, that's okay, I guess. Well, I'll tell you what. I guess it's not good enough. It's anything much. So there we go. The incredibly... The sensational Playmoto there. Getting the first position. Would not have seen that. What with all the controversy that has been surrounding Playmoto of late. Very little difference in pit strategy among all the drivers. An interesting one from Cybergal, who finished second. Coming in quite late. Playmoto also coming in quite late. Staying out on the intermediates for really as long as they possibly could. Obviously, scrutineering doesn't bother me, because, you know, I'm not good enough to have illegal parts. So, at the end of the day, we were... Ooh, what were we looking at here? 9.5 seconds behind where we needed to be. Flipping trolley fodder. Couldn't he break his car? So, no bonus cash. Gomez basically threw the race away by colliding with Double Zero and Bird Dog, I think. All three of them involved in some kind of fracas. So that puts Faith into 10th place overall in the championship, 2 points ahead of Mostly Sane. Gomez, meanwhile, is battling for last, being as he is only 6 points ahead of Steve Mush. Bulldozer Power, 96 points for the season, 26 ahead of Predator. I think we probably can take the pressure off finishing in 10th. I think 9th looks pretty good. Meanwhile, Harper Kanjo, who is a fan, apparently. Dragon Race Team China fans have to be insane. It's basically masochism, if you say so. Motor Racing Magazine, Juro Kagawa, Bulldozer Power, Phantom Sales in midfield. They'll be hoping for more in the future. I think that's one of Juro Kagawa's three standard statements. Meanwhile, he's back again. Fairly average performance for Bulldozer Power. They must be looking on enviously at Silver Racing. I know who Silver Racing are, and I don't care. So Gomez gets a bump in morale. Nobody else gets anything discernible. For some reason, my backup driver has gained some points in stuff. But, you know, the likelihood he ever sees a steering wheel while working for me is, you know, pretty remote. Kurt, meanwhile, he's gained 24% happiness, having lost 50% of it when I asked him for £1.5 million. So that's back on track once again. So 800 grand down the pan, nothing really to show for it, but at least we can still turn up to another three races, and with a positive outcome from the next sponsorship round, maybe even further than that. On the podium, Playmoto, Cybergout, and My Left Knee Hurts, which for the championship means that Milan Z is now only 5 points clear. Interesting. Knee Hurts in second, Macked in third. So there we go. Moto topping the sheets in Munich. Lap time 1:41 was pretty slow. Anthony finished third for Bulldozer Power. Continues to be strong. That's from practice. Why are you telling me this now? Gary is telling me that cars are broken as ever. Meanwhile, Michel Dupont from Moto Sportif. Should we do an interview? Sure. Andre Gomez was given a penalty for a collision. What do you have to say to the GMA? The GMA have got a lot to answer for. Andre is a top driver. Nothing really. Seemed like a fair penalty. The only thing I have to say is to Andre, that was an awful mistake. Actually, I would choose that one, given how little I think of Andre. But when it comes down to it, that's not strongly enough worded. So I'm going to take the safe one in the middle. And Andre still hacked off, nonetheless. Because I'd rather have a driver quit who is as lackluster as Andre is than incur a fine from the GMA. Central Sports Network, hard fought win for Moto, blah, 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 blah. Talking about other drivers, I'm definitely not fussed. Anyway, the next race in 24 days, we will be off to Guildford. The delight of Surrey, where top speed cornering of both medium and high speed is critical, and it's expected to rain. And as you know already, we really do extraordinarily well in the wet. So I hope to see you for that one. Thanks very much for tuning in today. Sling a like at this one if you enjoyed the race. Subscribe if you've not yet done so, and I'll catch up with you very soon. Cheerio.